Welcome everyone to this week's episode of Unrooted Men's Soccer Edition. And my guest for this week's show is none other than one of the freshmen on the men's soccer team here at Menlo College, Raghauv Taneja. Raghauv, thanks so much for joining me on the show.
Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome. Now, I want to start about talking about football, which is a little odd to begin a show, but I did it last week with JP Mendoza, yeah. And he told me that he's converting you into an Oakland Raiders fan. How has that been going so far?
So yeah, he made me watch a couple of games with his family, and that was the only team I've watched so far, because before that I only watched football in American movies. So it's disappointing that they're leaving Oakland. This is the last year, but they're the local team. They're not very good, but we have to support them.
Yeah, no, they're not one of the best teams. The 49ers being undefeated right now, little bit on the better side, but when you're watching the games with someone like JP, who's a passionate fan, a knowledgeable fan, and you get to go watch the game with his family. Yeah. They're also big Raiders fans. I'm sure that's quite enjoyable for you.
Yeah, so I tried not liking the Raiders, but then everyone got angry at me. So I had no choice.
Yeah, if you're going to watch a Raiders game with Raiders fans and you choose to root against the Raiders, they're not your friends anymore. They become your enemies, because they are a very passionate fan base, no doubt. Now, as someone who hails from India, obviously football isn't that big out there. So like you said, this was your first real experience watching football. Who had you heard of anyone prior to coming over here to America?
So I'd only heard of Tom Brady, because everyone's heard of him.
Because everyone's heard of Tom Brady, and he's always in the Super Bowl every single year. Well, if there's one thing that I'm going to teach you something right here. If there's one thing you should know, don't like Tom Brady.
Am I not supposed to?
Well, if you're a Patriots fan, you can like him. If you don't like the Patriots, everyone wants to see New England lose.
Yeah.
So I always like to root against him. It's not nice of me to do, but that's just how I operate. So stay with the Raiders. Yeah. Absolutely. Stick with the Raiders. Like them for as long as they're here. And don't like Tom Brady.
Tom Brady.
That's just my opinion. I'm sure other people on your team might disagree with me, but that is my opinion. Yeah. Stick with it or not, I don't really care. But that's just my two cents. Now, you're a long ways from home, obviously. New Delhi is where you're from in India. What were some of the things that you found particularly appealing that made you want to come out here to Menlo College?
So I like the soccer program, and I like what the team is about. So I came for the ID camp last year, and I met a couple of people in the team. And not only the soccer program, but the location of Menlo College, like, it's in Silicon Valley, and as an entrepreneur major myself, it's like the best place to be for internships, for technology, for business. Yeah,
I mean, it's very tough to beat this location, no doubt about it. You are surrounded by so much. I mean, we're just talking sports, right? You got a ton of sports teams in the area. Silicon Valley, a ton of business giants out here. Facebook, Apple, Google, everybody is right here in the area. So it's very tough to beat, and that's why the business degree at Menlo College is as valuable as it is. Now let's talk a little bit about the soccer program here. The Oaks got back in the win column last week. You picked up a pair of wins away from home. What adjustments did you guys make in practice that set yourself up to rebound?
So I think we changed our mentality. So from training hard, we started training like killers. So that means we have to go in aggressive every tackle. We can't be weak. We have to be strong mentally. We have to train hard every session.
I like that. Yeah. So you feel that there was maybe a bit of a lack of focus on being killers the week before against Merced? Yeah, I like that, because the Oaks typically are a team that goes out there and plays just 110% every time. And so maybe you kind of take that for granted sometimes and come back and you put that focus to work. And it showed last week, definitely, with the two wins. What's really been impressive has been the way that the Oaks have handled business against NCAA schools. You've played three of them so far, and you're 3-0. Why do you guys seem to play better against schools that are supposedly supposed to be better than you guys?
So again, I think it's a lot to do with the mentality. So the older players step up, the more experienced players, against better teams, because of the fact that they think they'll be better. So against worse teams, you can't actually put that extra drive in, but when you play against better teams, you prepare mentally better and stuff.
Yeah, and like you said, it comes back down to being a killer mentality, and also showing that, hey, we belong with these guys. We can compete with them. And you said the veterans on your team, you guys certainly have a lot of veterans, mm-hmm. no doubt about it. Now, we're seeing a lot of good stuff from another freshman on the team, Caden Mink. He's an attacker, and he scored two more goals last week. He's got already three in his freshman year. What have you noticed from his game that's allowed him to be so successful?
So I think he's one of the most professional players on our team, on and off the pitch. So he trains the way he'd play in games with like 110%. And off the pitch, he eats well, he sleeps on time, he does everything the way he should. And I think the small things matter, so that helped his game.
That's absolutely incredible to hear you say that that's the case with a freshman on the team, especially in a group of veterans like you have, a group of seniors, that he's one of the most professional guys on the team. That speaks volumes about Caden Mink. Now, the Oaks are back at home this week. Final non-conference game before you got Westmont in 1 week. How are you hoping to use this last week of preparation in order to fine-tune some things for Westmont?
So I think some players are still not certain which position they'd be best in. So I think we might change that around for the game, like play wingers up top or on the side to see what works best for the conference.
And certainly the Oaks have a huge conference game to open up. They take on Westmont Saturday, October 5th. Everybody needs to be at Wunderlich Field at 1:30 because that game could be the game of the year. All right, Raghav, let's get into the final segment of the show. It's called Brownie Bites. I'm going to ask you three off-the-wall questions. Give me your best answers. Question number one, which teammate would make the rowdiest cricket fan?
So I think it would be Ian because he likes baseball, and an equivalent to hitting a home run in baseball would be hitting a six, and there are a lot of those in cricket, so he'd just get really excited every time that happens.
Are there a lot of rowdy cricket fans?
Yeah, for sure.
Really?
So I went for the World Cup this summer. Mm-hmm. It was in England, and it was India versus Australia, and I think 95% of the stadium were just Indians.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that there was an actual World Cup for cricket.
Yeah.
Is it that? I mean, it's that big of an international game?
Yeah. So India versus Pakistan is actually more watched than El Clasico.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, I never would have guessed that. And you got a chance to go to the World Cup.
Yeah.
What was that experience like for you?
That was the first cricket game I've actually been to. And it was really good. I felt like I was at home because there were just so many Indians all around.
And would you go back again?
Yeah.
That's what matters right there. Question number two, which teammate would look the best in an old school 70s workout video?
I think it would be Angie. Because I can just imagine him wearing a Velcro headband and lifting weights.
You're right. That actually, as soon as you said Angelo, I thought to myself, you know, I don't know why he would fit, but he would. Just would fit. It would just look, I think because he's also a kind of guy he's got a smile on his face a lot, and he can kind of, this is weird, but like he can kind of, if someone's recording him doing a workout, I feel like he could interact and try to motivate the other person who's on the other side of the video camera, and I think that'd just be really funny. And yeah, seeing him in a headband would be hilarious. I want to see him out on the field with a headband. That would be pretty good. Headband Angie, let's make it happen. And then question number three, which teammate could handle the spiciest wings?
I'd have to say myself.
Really? You like spicy food?
Yeah.
How spicy can you go?
So in Monterey Bay, we went, off the game, we went to the market, and then there was a place that had the spiciest sauce. So you had to actually sign a form before trying it. And Esteban and I both tried it, and it wasn't that spicy for me.
Really?
Yeah.
What did Esteban think?
He couldn't talk.
He straight up couldn't talk?
Yeah, you just quiet for like 10, 15 minutes.
Oh my goodness. Now see, I'm from that area, so I know about what you're talking about, but I've never done it because I hate spicy foods.
Yeah.
So if they're legitimately making me sign a waiver, I am definitely out on that. Yeah. There's no chance whatsoever. What is, and I'm putting you on the spot here, but what is the spiciest thing you've ever had in your life?
So back home, my mom makes these potatoes, and they're really spicy.
What does she put in them?
She just puts too much red chili. So like, I have curd with it because I just can't manage to have it on my own.
So you will admit that is almost too spicy.
Yeah, that's too spicy.
But yet you still eat it anyways. Yeah. Because you're a legend, that's why. Raghav, thanks for joining me on the show.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Folks, the men's soccer team off this weekend after their game on Thursday against Holy Names University, and it's all in preparation for their first GSAC game. They take on fifth-ranked Westmont College. the team that bounced them out of the playoffs last year. That matchup on October 5th, Wunderlich Field. The men's game starts at 1:30, and we need your support out there. If you can't make it out, the game will be live streamed on the Menlo College Sports Network. We invite you to tune into the next episode of Unrooted Men's Soccer Edition when Raghauv Taneja will select the next interviewee by me, Brian Brownfield, right here on the show. Until then, we'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.